Hello and welcome back. In this video, we are going to take a look at the non-saturating version of the half-wave rectifier. So I've drawn here my non-saturating active half-wave rectifier circuit. Notice that it resembles an inverting amplifier, except for the fact that there are two additional diodes, D1 and D2. I've also labeled, as I did in previous cases, both the output of the circuit, which is what's labeled Vout, on one side of D2, and the output of the op amp, which I've labeled Vout prime on the other side of D2. And we're going to perform our analysis by taking a look first at the positive half cycle of the input signal and then at the negative half cycle of the input signal. So for the positive half cycle, meaning for V in values that are greater than zero, we can see that since Vin is being applied at the inverting terminal of the op-amp, for a positive value of Vin, since the positive input terminal is sitting at ground, that means if the negative input terminal is higher than the positive input terminal, the output of the op-amp is going to want to trend towards negative values. And so that means that Vout prime, the output of the op-amp, will trend towards values that are less than zero or negative. And if that is the case, since, again, the positive input terminal is sitting at zero, that means that as long as we have a negative feedback loop formed, the negative input terminal of the op-amp is also sitting very close to zero, which means that one side of D1 is sitting at approximately zero, the other side is the output of the op-amp is trending towards a negative voltage. That means we're going to make the assumption that D1 is going to turn on. And with D2, the opposite thing happens. D2 is going to be off because it's reversed in orientation with respect to D1. And therefore, we can see, just to make things a bit clearly, I'm going to assume if D1 is on, that means it's forward biased. D2 is off, that means it's reverse biased. So it's an open circuit. So I'm just going to cross it like that. And if we look at the circuit, we will see that in that case, the output voltage is going to be equal to zero because there's going to be the negative input terminal of the op-amp sitting at 0 volts, meaning this node is sitting at 0 volts as well, virtual ground. And there is no current flowing through RF and therefore no voltage drop across RF, which means Vout is equal to zero. And since we do have a negative feedback loop formed through diode D1, Vout prime is going to, the output of the op-amp is going to reach whatever value it needs to reach to make sure that those two input terminals are sitting at the same voltage or approximately the same voltage. And therefore, it's just going to be, since one side is sitting at 0 volts or virtual ground, the other side is going to be sitting at negative 0.7 volts. So Vout prime will be around negative 0.7 volts. And Vout, which is the output of the rectifier circuit, will be sitting at, oops, not prime there, that's Vout, will be sitting at 0 volts. For the negative half cycle, let me take out the annotations. For the negative half cycle, let's see what happens. So V in less than zero. Again, since Vin is being applied at the negative input terminal, we expect that as long as there is a negative feedback path, Vout prime is going to want to go towards a positive value, which means in terms of the diode connections or whether they're forward biased or reverse biased, it's going to be opposite to the previous case because now Vout prime is positive, so D1 is going to turn off, and D2 is going to turn on. And so if that is the case, so D1 is reverse biased, let's assume it's not there, it's an open circuit, and D2 is the one that is forward biased, that means that now the negative feedback path is going through D2 and through RF. And so we have essentially something that resembles very much an inverting amplifier, with the exception of diode D2. All that's going to do, that diode is going to do, is simply that the output of the op-amp is just going to be 0.7 volts higher than in a negative an inverting amplifier. Because again, the output of the op-amp is just going to be whatever it needs to be to make sure that those two input terminals are sitting at approximately the same voltage. And so Vout prime, in this case, will be equal to negative RF over RI times Vin plus 0.7 volts, meaning 0.7 volts higher than the standard inverting amplifier, so that the output can be sitting at negative RF over RI times Vin. If we wanted to plot the voltage transfer characteristic for the circuit, a plot of Vout versus Vin, output voltage versus input voltage, we'll just take a look at this and say, well, for positive values of Vin, looks like Vout is going to be equal to zero. So that's what it looks like. And for negative values of Vin, Vout is negative RF over RI times Vin, which is basically in the second quadrant. Because since the Vin values are going to be negative, the negative RF over RI times the negative Vin will give us a positive Vout. And the slope of this line will be negative RF over RI. So again, for a set of values of Vin, in this case, the negative values of Vin, since we have an inverting configuration, the output is proportional to the input, or in with a negative sign, but still proportional to the input. And for the other polarity of input signals, in this case positive input signals, the output is equal to zero. If I wanted to do a time domain representation of what's happening, I could plot my Vin signal versus time. Maybe I'll do that in blue. And if I have, let's say, my sinusoidal Vin, again, my Vout will be, for positive Vin signals, will be zero. For negative Vin signals, will be negative some gain times Vin. Let's assume that in this case, the gain is bigger than one. And so this is more or less what the output will look like. Main advantage of this circuit is, again, since it is a non-saturating version of the op-amp, of the half-wave rectifier, that implies that it's going to have better frequency response than the inverting, than the saturating version that we saw earlier. Better frequency response. Perhaps you could mention as a limitation the fact that it is an inverting configuration, and you may not want to do inverted rectification. You may just want to do a rectification where you let the positive input signals through or amplify positive input signals. And in that case, it shouldn't be too big of a deal. You can just run the signal through another inverting stage and get your polarity back to the right place. But you could think of it as a limitation if you were not interested in having that inversion. If you wanted, you could move the location of that slope that we have in the second quadrant, in that voltage transfer characteristic for the circuit, to the fourth quadrant. And the way you will go about doing that is, as usual, you will be reverting the orientations of your diodes. And so I have redrawn the circuit where the orientations of D1 and D2 have been reversed with respect to the previous circuit. And we can see that the analysis is going to be exactly the opposite as in the previous case. In this case, for Vin positive, meaning positive input values greater than zero of the input signal, Vout prime is when I want to trend negative. But since the orientation of D1 and D2 are reversed, in this case, D1 is the one that is going to be reverse biased or off, and D2 is the one that's going to be forward biased or on. And therefore, the value of Vout is going to be, in this case, negative RF over RI times Vin, And then for negative input voltages, Vout prime will want to turn positive. And again, due to the reverse orientation of the diodes, in this case, D1 will be on, D2 will be off or reverse bias, and Vout will be equal to zero. And so essentially what we have done is, if this is Vin and that is Vout, is that for positive values of Vin, Vout is negative RF over RI times Vin, therefore Vout has a negative value. And for negative values of Vin, Vout is equal to zero. The slope of this line is negative RF over RI. And in terms of our input, output, or time domain plot, if I have the same sinusoidal signal with respect to time as before, my output now is going to be negative for positive values of Vin, potentially with a gain greater than 1, 0 for negative values of Vin. And that's it. Again, since it's a non-saturating type of circuit, it's going to have a better frequency response than the saturating version. But notice that the constant in the half-wave rectifier circuits is always that the output is proportional to the input for a given polarity of input signal and equal to zero for the other polarity of input signal. Thank you.